Question number 161. An enzyme that catalyzes the breakdown of sucrose into glucose and fructose is a. Now we know that the enzyme that breaks down sucrose into glucose and fructose is sucrase or invertase. Let us look at the options. Ligases are enzymes which catalyze the
joining
of two substrates. Option number 2, lyases. Lyases are enzymes which catalyze the cleavage of substrate molecule into two parts without using water. At the end of the reaction with lyases, the products have a double bond. Let us look at option number 3, hydrolases. So here the larger molecules will be broken down into smaller molecules with the help of water. Examples over here are sucrase, lactase, amylase, protease, etc. Option number 4 are dehydrogenases. These dehydrogenases are the enzymes which mostly catalyze reduction oxidation reactions. So in this case, the enzyme that catalyzes the breakdown of sucrose is sucrase, which falls under the category of hydrolases. So the answer becomes option number 3. Let us see the next question, students. Question number 162. Read the following statements carefully and choose the correct option. Option number 1. Ribozymes and ribonuclease P are DNA based enzymes. So this becomes an incorrect option, as ribozyme and ribonuclease P are RNA based enzymes. Let's look at option number 2. Fructose is a polymer of inulin. This also is an incorrect statement, because inulin is a fructan. That is, inulin is a polymer of fructose, whereas in option 2 it says vice versa. So this option also becomes incorrect. Number 3. Apoenzyme is the non-proteinaceous part of the enzyme. This also is an incorrect option, as apoenzyme is the proteinaceous part of the enzyme. This apoenzyme combines with a cofactor, which is a non-proteinaceous part to form the holo enzyme or the complete enzyme. Therefore, this option is also incorrect. Now, number 4. Zinc acts as an inorganic cofactor for carboxypeptidase. This absolutely is a correct option. Carboxypeptidase is a protease. So, zinc acts as an inorganic cofactor for carboxypeptidase is the correct statement. So, the answer becomes option number 4. Let us see the next question. Question number 163. The given diagram is related to anatomical regions of human stomach. Choose the option which denotes the correct labeling. Let us see. V describes esophagus, X describes fundus, Y describes the cardiac part of the stomach, Z describes the body of the stomach, W describes the pyloric part of the stomach. So over here we have to match the
notations
with the parts of stomach. Over here, let's see. X is fundus part. So, this option is incorrect. X is fundus and Z is the body part. This option is correct. W is the pyloric part. Therefore, this option is also incorrect. Now, W is the pyloric part. Y denotes the cardiac part of the stomach. So, this option is also incorrect. So, the answer in this case becomes option number 2. That is, X denotes fundus and Z denotes the body of the stomach. Let us see the next question, students. Question number 164. Term that does not describe human dentition is thecodont, pleurodont, diphyodont or heterodont. Let us understand these terms. Thecodont is a condition in which the teeth are embedded in the bony sockets. This condition is present in humans. Number 2 is pleurodont. Pleurodont is a condition that is exemplified by fangs of snake. This is a condition in which teeth are fixed at lateral surface of the jaw ridge. Therefore, this condition is not present in humans as our teeth are not laterally present on the jaw ridge. They are completely embedded in the jawbone. Number 3 is diphyodont. It means that humans have two sets of teeth, that is deciduous and permanent teeth. So, this condition is present in humans. And hetero means different, don't means teeth. So, heterodont is presence of different types of teeth. This condition is also present in humans as we have different types of teeth like incisors, canines, premolars and molars. So, the answer in this case becomes option number 2. Let's see the next question, students. Question number 165. Match column 1 with column 2 and choose the correct match with respect to general site of absorption. So, in column 1 we have the organs and in column 2 we have the substances. Let us look at the correct table. Mouth is the place where most of the drugs are absorbed. So, A should match with 3. Stomach, that is B, the absorption of alcohol takes place in stomach. Number C, absorption of glucose takes place in small intestine and absorption of most minerals takes place in the large intestine. So, let us look at the options. A matches with 3, B matches with 1, C matches with 2 and D matches with 4. So, our answer in this case becomes option number 1. Let us move on to the next question.